The another type of nested inner class is method local inner class. So let us see what does this method local inner class does. It says that a method local inner class is nothing but where you are defining an inner class inside a method of your outer class. And when you define an inner class or the nested class inside the method of your outer class, that becomes your local method, that becomes your local class or a local variable. Like a local variable, scope is nothing but inside that particular method. Similarly, when you declare a local class, that is nothing but a local inner class inside the method, its access or its scope is limited to that particular method. Its scope, or you cannot access outside the method. For an example, in a print method, you have created a variable called int num equal to 10. Now, this integer is local variable to that particular print method. Similarly, in this print method, if you have created a nested class, then this nested class becomes local to that particular method and cannot be accessed outside. Next, it says that a method local inner class can be instantiated within the method that or where you have declared your inner class. Again, taking an example of a print method, if you have created an inner class in this print method, then you need to instantiate the object of this inner class within that particular method. So let us understand this in detail with the help of an example. In this example, we have created a class which is an outer class, public class, and the class name is method local inner class. This is our outer class. And in this outer class, we have created an instance variable int num equal to 20. Then we have created a method for this particular class where we are trying to create a method for our outer class, right? The method is public void demo. And now in this method, we are declaring an inner class. When we declare a nested or an inner class within a method of outer class, then it is called as method local inner classes. So in this, we have created a class called class inner class. And in this class, we are displaying a method called, this is method inner class, right? So we have created a method called display. In that, we are writing system.out.println to print this particular message plus the integer value that we are getting from our instance variable. So one thing that we remember is that under the method we can call the value or our instance variable, right? Similarly, now this inner class is written inside the method. So this inner class acts local to this method and can access the instance variable, right? So this method will display the value and the output. We have closed the method and then closed the inner class. The next thing that we need to remember about method local inner classes is that we need to instantiate the inner class within the method. So the method, we haven't closed the method, we have just closed the method of inner class and then closed the inner class. Now, under the method of outer class, we need to instantiate the inner class. So the inner class, what is its name? Inner underscore class. Then we have created the object name equal to new inner class. Then we call the method display with the object, that is in class dot display. So this is how where you create a nested inner class, which is nothing but your local inner, right? So this is nothing but your local method inner classes. Now, how would you call under your static void main method? You instantiate your outer class and then you call the method of your outer class, the method which consists of your inner class. So object dot demo. Now the outer class method will be called and this method which is called will perform these actions. So let us run this program practically to understand how does a method local inner class works. We have created a class called method local inner class and this class will help us understanding how you can declare a nested or an inner class inside the method of your outer class. Here the outer class name is method local inner class, which is of public type. It cannot be of a private access modifier as class needs to be accessed
by any other class within the package or outside the package. However, the nested classes helps us or provides us a behavior of defining the inner classes as private. So here we have created an outer class called method local inner class, and in that we have declared an instance variable with the value 20. Then we have created a method called public void demo, and this method is nothing but to provide as a demo about method local inner class. And this method local inner class is nothing but where you declare your inner class inside the method of your outer class. So here demo is a method for your outer class. You create a class, inner class, and in that basis you will perform the operation that you would want to. Here we have created a method called public void display, where we are trying to display the output as this is an example of inner class plus num, that is plus your instance variable value. Because this inner class is a member or is a local member to your method, here every methods are local member to your main class. Here int number is a local variable for your outer class. Similarly, this class which is declared inside the method is local member to your class. Therefore, it will be able to access your instance variable value. Now you close your inner class inside the method. In our previous example, where we had instantiated the inner class inside another object of your outer class. Whereas in case of method local inner class, you need to instantiate the inner class inside the same method where you are declaring your inner class. So here is the end of your inner class, and now we need to access the inner class members. How would you do that? You need to first instantiate it. That is your inner class name, object name equals to new inner class, open and close brackets, and then semicolon. Now you have to call the display method of your inner class with the help of its object. So in class dot the display method. So in this case, we have declared instantiated and then call the display method of the inner class within the same method of a outer class. So the same method is nothing but your demo method. Now the second step would be to instantiate or initialize your inner outer class variable. So you write your outer class name and then you instantiate its object equals to new and your outer class name. And then you would call this method that will run your inner class. So you write object dot demo. So this is how you write your method local inner class, where in the previous one you were trying to create just a normal inner class under your outer class. That's the reason you were instantiating in a different method. Whereas when you say method local inner class, you have to create and instantiate that particular inner class within the method of your local class. So let us save and run this file. That is control S F11. So it shows this is an example of inner class 20. Therefore, once you have instantiated your outer class, it calls its method, and this method then creates this inner class, right? For that, it calls the inClass.display method, and which will display your output plus the integer.